who have been entertaining us from Sexy Salsa Ballroom. And they have a few words to speak to you about this organization. Welcome, Marissa and Adam Casey.
From Hungary, came to the States in 2006. Wonderful dancer and singer, and speaks many languages, or actually sings in many languages, rather. Anyway, so our plan after I finish speaking is we're gonna do one final dance, which is the salsa. Does everybody know what salsa? Yeah. Yay! All right. Okay. And then after our dance, everyone, and I say everyone, is gonna get up and we're all gonna learn the salsa basics together. Yay! Woo! Okay, so before our final dance, I have a little story that I just wanted to share. And from Mr. Ray, from what I hear from Mr. Ray's, this is a fundraiser for Academia Moderna, in particular for building a library. Is that correct? Is that correct? Yes. Okay. Now, once he told me about that, I thought about, you know, what kind of books did I really like, you know, reading when I was a child? And I realized that one thing I really liked reading was biographies and autobiographies of famous people. And the reason why I really enjoyed reading biographies of famous people was because they were very inspirational. Okay, despite all these challenges that they went through, there was always light at the end of the tunnel. So, for example, Helen Keller, who was somebody I really, really looked up to. She was blind, she was deaf, but she did many wonderful things. And so did Martin Luther King Jr. So all these people I really, really idolized. And the reason why I'm mentioning this is because 6 years ago, I was paralyzed from the neck down. And, you know, I've been a dancer all my life, and trust me, when I was paralyzed, and when I say paralyzed, I mean paralyzed. I mean, I wasn't able to walk, I couldn't lift my arms, and you know, the nurse would take me to the bathroom, and like literally my brain would say pee, but nothing would come out, okay? So anyway, I was diagnosed with a severe neurological disease called spinal cord infarction, and pretty much the doctor told me after I was diagnosed that I would never walk again. And hearing that news as a dancer was just, oh my God, I mean, I'm telling you, I fainted, I cried, I really thought my life was over. But when I was in bed, I was thinking, you know what? Helen Keller, despite being blind, despite being deaf, she persevered. And all these, you know, famous people I read about, the Wright brothers, Martin Luther King Jr., yeah, Rockefeller, all these people I have read about started coming through my mind and motivated me to get better. And guess what? 3 years later, I, again, profession. And I'm sharing this story because, you know, the library, you know, library obviously is a place to check out books. It's also a place for school, for kids to become responsible to borrow books and return them. But you never know what a book is going to bring into someone's life. As we know from the law of attraction, what you put your mind on is what you get out. Okay? So anyway, I hope everyone, I'm not sure what, you know, how you guys are, I know that there's auction items, et cetera, but I hope everyone would put their checkbooks out and write donate whatever it is that they feel is good for themselves. We are auctioning off, actually I'm donating two items. I'm also a dance teacher, and I teach in the community. So I'm gonna be auctioning off two-hour private lessons. So whether it's salsa, ballroom, you name it, we'll teach you, okay? Wow. And they are worth $200 each. So after we dance and after we salsa dance, go to the back table and sign up, okay? Yeah. All right. So are you ready for our last dance? Yeah. Hey, all right.
Mr. Schmidt.